Ever wonder why you can skip meals and cut calories but never see the scale budge? Well, weight loss secrets coming up. It's easy to blame yourself for a lack of willpower when you are not winning the battle of the bulge, but the secret could be in balancing your hormones. Here to tell us all how to give ourselves a hunger hormone makeover is Marjorie Nolan Cohn, national spokesperson for the Academy of Nutrition and Dietetics and author of Belly Fat Fix. How are you? Nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
So this is so interesting to me. It's all about your hormones, or at least they play a big role in maintaining a healthy body weight.
Hormones are the signalers in our body. They are the control center. And we now know that hormones play a role in not only weight gain, but our inability to lose weight once we're already overweight or obese.
So let's talk about the two hormones that are kind of responsible, one for making you feel hungry and one for making you feel satiated. Mm-hmm. And the first one is the one that makes you feel hungry, and it's called ghrelin.
Yes.
How does ghrelin work?
Well, ghrelin works on a schedule that we can predict but we can't control. And it's secreted by special cells in the lining of our stomach. And it's also secreted in the certain areas of our brain that control metabolism, thirst, hunger, as well as a part of our brain called the mesolimbic reward system pathway.
So how do you get a ghrelin reduction? Right?
Right. Well, ghrelin is really interesting in that there's no way to shut it off. The only way to shut it off and to tune it down is to actually eat. So it starts by eating on ghrelin's schedule, not necessarily your schedule. We know through science and research that ghrelin peaks about three times a day, at 8 a.m., 12 p.m., 6 p.m., and then there's a smaller peak around 3 p.m., which coincides perfectly with the evolutionary times of meals.
What are ghrelin-suppressing foods?
Lean beef, 95% or more fat-free, as well as non-fat plain Greek yogurt, because it's low in sugar and high in protein, and white fish also is a very ghrelin-suppressing food, because we can eat a lot of it for a little bit of calories.
So you're really looking for foods that sort of placates the ghrelin
exactly.
hormone.
Thinking in terms of the carbohydrate category, we want to aim for lentils or beans, sweet potatoes, and rolled oats. Those are also very ghrelin-suppressing foods, because they're high in fiber, and they're high in a component called resistant starch. Resistant starch is something that we're just starting to recognize in the food industry, and it's a starch, but it functions like fiber in that it slows down digestion and helps us feel full longer. And those are just some of the really highly ghrelin-suppressing foods.
All right, let's talk about leptin. Now, leptin is the hormone that tells you, thanks, I'm full.
Actually, leptin is produced in our fat cells. And when someone is at a healthy weight, their ghrelin and leptin is balanced perfectly. Think of a seesaw that's straight across. What happens when someone gains weight and becomes overweight, they have a lot of fat cells, right? So naturally you would think, well, if I have a lot of fat cells, they're producing a lot of leptin, and therefore I should always feel full. The problem is when we become overweight, our body actually becomes leptin resistant.
Okay, so you say that you can actually reset your ghrelin, mm-hmm. which is that hunger hormone, mm-hmm. and lose weight in even 3 days. How do you reset it?
Well, it starts by eating on ghrelin's schedule. It's also really important to drink enough water. We're always preaching drink more water when you're trying to lose weight. Well, thirst and hunger are easily confused. We also want to make sure that we're eating those ghrelin-suppressing foods. And the other key element is making sure that you don't exercise too much. When you exercise too much, which is something that I see often with people wanting to lose weight, they hit the gym thinking it's going to help by doing a lot of cardio, when actually exercising too much sends a starvation signal to those ghrelin-producing cells, and it makes you want to eat more, and it actually stimulates more ghrelin production.
When you say don't over-exercise, what does that mean?
It means cut back on the cardio. Resistance training, focusing on muscle growth and muscle repair is the most important thing, because that's actually going to stimulate a metabolic process, which ultimately burns more calories.
This is an exciting new area of research. Do you think as sort of the medical establishment understands these hormones better, it will be easier for people to maintain a healthy body weight?
The ghrelin-leptin balance was really only discovered within the past 6 to 7 years. So it's only now that we're able to apply it to real life. Until now, it's only been information that scientists have known about.
Marjorie Nolan Cohn, thank you so much. It's so interesting.
Thank you.
And hopefully it will help a lot of people. And meanwhile, thank you for watching. You can see all the episodes of Katie's Take on abcnews.com and Yahoo, and learn more about my show at katiecurric.com. We'll see you next time.